Hello friends, in this video lecture we will learn how we can read an Excel file and how we can write the whole content in another Excel file or in the same Excel file in different sheet. So to perform this task, first of all we have to use Excel application scope activity, and my file is exist with the name of a.xlsx, and this file is available in the desktop. So first of all I have to copy the path of the file. So here just you can see the path of the file is c:\user/sunit.gupta. Okay, so just I am pasting the path of the file with double quotes, and after then I am providing the file name a.xlsx. After then we have to read the data available in a.xlsx. So for that we go with the read range activity. So here our content is available in sheet 1. Okay, so just here it is, we have to provide the sheet number, and here we can pass empty string within double quotes. It means this activity read the whole content of the file, and if you want to read the content in a certain region, then you have to pass the index value. Okay, so in the read range activity you can see that output is provided right here, and we have to store the content after execution of this activity in a data table. So for that I have to create a variable. So for that I press the key Ctrl+K, and name of this data variable is dt1. Next one is, so read range activity is applied on which file? That is a.xlsx file. So just up to now we open the Excel file, we read the content of Excel file, and that content is stored in data table named as dt1. After then I would like to write the same content in same Excel file but sheet is different. So again I am using write range activity. So here I am changing the name of the sheet, so that is 2. From where writing will start, so that is a1 shell. Now here I have to pass the name of the variable. Okay, now there is no error. So first of all just we check the Excel file. Okay, so there is no sheet 2. Okay, and in sheet 1 the content is provided. Now I execute the sequence. Okay, so I'm running it, let's see. Okay, so here just you can see whatever content is available in sheet 1, name, city, age, education, all the things. Okay, so header name is not there, but the whole content is copied in sheet number 2. Now from here you can see that one option is there, that is add header. So if I'll check it, then header names are also available in different sheet. So I'm again running it, just you can see it here. Okay, so execution started, and let's see. So here just you can see the file name is a.xlsx, name, city, age and education. So previously these headers was not there, but after putting a checkbox in add header, the same information is available with header. So up to now What we did? We opened Excel file. The name of the file is a.xlx. Just we are reading the content exists in a.xlx with sheet number 1. Same content is stored in variable dt1, and using write range activity, the same content is copied and pasted in sheet number 2. Now, let's say another Excel file is there. So, in my case, another Excel file is there with name b.xlsx. Here, just you can see that sheet 1, only one sheet is there, and there is no content. Now, I would like to write the content in b.xlsx file. So, again, suppose I want to open a different sheet, then I have to use Excel application scope, and the name of the file is b.xlsx. So here I am writing the name of the file. Now you can see that b.xlsx, and I would like to write the content stored in variable dt1. Okay, so here just I go with write range activity, write range, okay, and here I am passing the name of the variable dt1. Okay, so some error is there because the scope of dt1 is limited. So what we can do, just we change the scope of the variable dt1. So here just you can see that some another variables are there which is unused. So first of all, I am removing all such variable by clicking in remove unused variable. Okay, now only two variables are there, and I am extending the scope of the variable dt1. Okay, so here just you can see that now in the whole code there is no error. Now the content exists in file a.xlsx is copied to the different Excel file. The name of the file is b.xlsx. Now I am running the code. So let's see what is the output. Okay. Name of the variable. So now it is dt2. Okay, so I think it is not working. So control K dt2. Okay, and here I am passing the dt2. Okay, so some, let's see what is the issue. The issue is due to the read range. The scope of variable dt2 is 2. So I'm changing the scope of the variable. Now it is Excel. Okay. Now just I'm deleting this cell. Okay. Now we check it. What is the output? So yes, in file b.xls the content is available, but there is no header. We select the write range activity and option is there, and simply you just click at here, and again we run the activity and see what is the output. So now you can see that in file v.xlx the headers are available. Copy the content.